Dataset schema is a way to tell search engines if a page contains research data, statistics, survey results, or any structured information. The better search engines understand your dataset, the more effective they can rank and present them in the search results. Typically, adding a dataset schema can get complicated, but as a RankMath Pro user, everything is straightforward. So if you're publishing data sets on your site, whether it is a climate research, financial statistics, or whatever, let me show you how to easily add the dataset schema markup to your pages. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users. And this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, especially if your company sells statistics, information, and data, this is going to be useful because big businesses that want an edge will likely find datasets through Google's dataset search tool. For example, WordPress hosting service market research. And here are some datasets found. Let's select, for example, this. These are all the schema information added to the dataset page. And as we visit the page, you can see that they do provide credible and solid information. But this is a site that sells premium reports. But regardless if you are selling your reports, as long as you want your datasets to be noticed by others, the dataset schema will be useful to you. And take note that the dataset schema is only available to RankMath Pro users. Anyway, let's talk about what can qualify as a dataset in the eyes of Google. So according to Google, a table or a CSV file with some data, an organized collection of tables, a file in a proprietary format that contains data, for example, a premium survey report that needs to be purchased, and all these are considered data sets. So if you have any of these elements on your page, you can apply the dataset schema. But how should we apply it? Let's get into it. The first thing is to make sure that on your RankMath dashboard, the schema structured data module is turned on. And then you want to visit the page where you intend to publish your statistics, surveys, or findings. Following that, click on the RankMath tab, visit the schema tab, and click on the schema generator. And the dataset schema is right here. Now, this schema type is only available for RankMath Pro users. So if you have the Pro version installed, you can click on this dataset. And now let's talk about what we should add to these fields. So assuming that I have done an in-depth research on a topic, the fastest loading WordPress page builders, I share my findings on this page and have an Excel sheet for people to download. Now this is a hypothetical report, okay? So let's go to the dataset schema and let's check out the first field, which is the name field. Now any fields marked with this red asterisk are mandatory fields. And it happens that the name and description fields are mandatory, which means if there are no inputs for these two fields, the schema markup will not work. But as you can see, by default, RankMath has added these two variables, such as the SEO title and description, such that it dynamically takes information from the SEO title and description fields through the edit snippet. So as long as your page has a title and content, the mandatory fields in the dataset schema will be filled. Anyway, this is basically the title of your dataset, just as you have seen on the dataset search tool. This is where the title of your dataset appears. You will see it in the snippet as well. So this field is really important because it is the first thing search engines and users see. So make it clear and descriptive. In our case, I would say fastest WordPress page builders report. Next, the description field. This should include a brief summary of your dataset. If you check out one of the search results in the dataset search, you will see the description of the report. It can be as long or as short as it needs to be. However, just take note that there is a length restriction for the Google Reach Results test. For example, this dataset has such a long description. If we visit the page, copy the URL, and do a test on the Google's Reach Results testing tool, give it a while, and you will see an error in the dataset schema. And as we expand the information and scroll down this long description, you will see this error where it says invalid string length in field description. And when you click to expand the error, it says that the supported string length is between 50 to 5,000 characters. So just take note of that. In my case, I've pre-written this description. And if the description is too long, you can always click here and drag it down to expand the view. Next, for the short code, if you want to display the content in the dataset schema on your page, you will copy and paste this short code on your page. For example, let's copy this, click save for this post. On your page, you want to click on the place to add the information and paste the short code. And as you save or publish the page, visit it, and you will see the schema information here. We have only entered the title and description of the dataset, which is what you are seeing. But anyway, if you want to display all the information in the schema, you can leverage the shortcode feature. Next is the URL field. This is typically the page you are applying this dataset schema, and is where your report, statistics, survey, or whatever lives. And for visual reference, on the dataset search, this is the button that will send the user to the URL you have provided. So back to the schema field, I will add the URL of this page right here. Following that is the same as view. If there is another page on the web that describes the dataset on your page, maybe you have referenced your data from another page, such as a government database, GitHub repository, or other related sources, you can add the URL of your reference page here. But for our case, I am the source of the dataset, so I will leave this view empty. Next is the identifier field. Now, I need to take a moment to explain this. Imagine you wrote a piece of research paper and you have published it to maybe an open source research website and you have a URL to find it. Then a few years later, that research website changes its URL structure and somehow deleted your paper from their database. You no longer have access to that paper. And that's where the identifier comes in. If your research paper or document is so important and you have no control over the platform where you publish, you'll want to register your work with sites like crossrev.org or datacite.org, where they will provide you with a unique identifier. It is a special code that always points to your dataset, even if your website or link changes over time. So if you check out this dataset, you will see this unique identifier. Back to the schema, if you have registered your dataset with the sites I've mentioned, you can click Add Property and paste the unique identifier here. And if you have more than one identifier, feel free to click Add Property. You can always remove the field if you don't need it. Next is the keywords field. This is where you add keywords that describe your dataset so that others can easily find it. Just like how you would optimize your page for the search engines. So in our case, we can add WordPress page builders, website performance, page speed, site optimization, drag and drop page builders. Let's add two more. We can say web development and fastest page builders. Now there is no limit to how many keywords you can add, but try to keep it between 5 to 10 keywords as a best practice. Focus on quality of the keywords and not the quantity in this case, to avoid over-optimization and provide clarity. Next is the license field. This is where you will tell users how they can use your data. If you have defined it in your privacy policy or any policy pages, you can add it here. I do see datasets using Creative Commons licenses, such as this, where as you click on the license link, it will bring you to the Creative Commons page. This is all directed by you and how you want others to use your research data. Some other examples include government license, as well as the privacy policy page for the site. For me, I will just add my privacy policy page. Let's move along to the data catalog field. This should contain the name of the catalog or repository where your dataset is published. It provides context about where your dataset belongs to. For example, if we visit this site, you can see that they have a lot of different data reports sorted under many categories. You just have to add the name of the category where the dataset page you're working on is stored. This should not be a URL if you're wondering. Just include the name of the category. However, if your dataset page is a standalone page and it is not stored under any catalogs, you can simply add a name that describes the dataset, or you can simply leave this field empty. Following that is the temporal coverage field. If your dataset is meant for example 2025, and in the next year you will have another dataset of your findings, you will add 2025 here. But if the dataset covers for a period of time, for example you have done a survey on 1000 people over the period of January 2025 to March 2025, you will add 2025, which is the year, -01, which is the month, and -01, which is the day, and then add a slash 2025-March-31. So this is the date format you should adopt. Now, if the dataset has an open-ended time period, you would add something like this, from this date to dot dot. I hope this is easy for you to understand. But for me, I will just add 2025. Next is the spatial coverage. This is the field that describes the geographic area your dataset covers. For example, I've done this fastest WordPress page builder report for the global audience. So I will write global here. But if the dataset is done specifically on a country, such as a weather report in Singapore, I would add Singapore here. Following that, we need to talk about this dataset view here. So if this dataset page you're working on is the standalone dataset, you do not have to click on Add Property Group, which in this case is a standalone dataset. However, assuming that this is not a standalone dataset, let's say that this dataset contains smaller subdatasets such as Core Web Vitals by Page Builder and Page Builder Test Configurations. In such a case, we need to add the HES part schema markup. This is easily achievable using this dataset section. Simply click Add Property Group and a set of schema fields will be added. The name of the subdataset is Core Web Vitals by Page Builder, so we will add it here. And then this is a short description of the subdataset. The license is what we have talked about. I will add my privacy policy link. And then I'm the creator of the dataset. So I will select person. If the dataset is provided by an organization, you want to select that. So over here, I will add my name. And this is my website link. Or you can add the URL to your LinkedIn profile. This is straightforward. Now, since there is another subdataset, over at the dataset section, I will click Add Property Group again. And now I will add the second dataset, which is Page Builder Test Configurations. This is the description, and then the license, and the rest are straightforward. So this is for cases where there are smaller datasets that are a part of a larger dataset you're working on. However, if the dataset you're working on is the smaller dataset that is part of the larger dataset, then you will need to customize the schema and add the is part of schema property. But I recommend that you complete all the fields in the dataset schema before customizing it. I will show you how to do that in a while, but for now, let's get back to the schema fields. So the final schema field is the distribution. If your dataset does not allow or do not have any options for people to download your report, then you do not need to do anything further. However, if you allow others to download your report in a certain format, for example PDF, you can click on Add Property Group and these additional fields will appear. Since we are allowing PDF downloads, we will add PDF in the encoding format. It can be in a document format, PowerPoint format, or whatever. Only one format should be added to this field. The information you add to this field will be displayed on the dataset search right here. So back to the schema fields, this content URL field should include the page where people can download the dataset. If the download link is available on a page you are working on, then it is the URL of that page. And if you have another encoding format, you can click Add Property Group again and add the format accordingly, together with the URL. Once done, click Save for this post and save or publish the page and the dataset schema will be added to the page. Now that we have completed the dataset schema markup, we've got to know if it works, so let's test it. To test if the dataset schema works, we've got to use the Google's Rich Results testing tool. But first, we've got to visit the page where we have added the schema. Right-click and view its page source. And then Ctrl or Command A to select everything, and Ctrl or Command C to copy the codes. Next, let's visit Google's Rich Results testing tool. This is the link. So what you want to do next is to select the code option and paste the copied codes here, and let's test it. Give it a while, and you will see that we have passed the dataset Rich Results test. And as you can see, it has detected three datasets, the larger dataset and the two smaller ones. And if you expand one of them, you will see that there are no errors or warnings, which means everything is in order. Now, there is one more thing we need to talk about the dataset schema, which is if the dataset you're working on is part of a larger dataset. Earlier, we talked about the HES part property, which binds other smaller datasets to the larger dataset you're working on. But now we'll talk about working on the smaller dataset, which is part of the larger dataset. All right, check this out. If we go to our dataset schema and we scroll to the dataset section, I have removed the smaller datasets we have talked about earlier. Now, we highly recommend that if you are adding the is part of property, you should complete all the information on this template before customizing it. So assuming that this dataset is part of a larger dataset called WordPress Performance Benchmarks 2025, so we need to add the is part of property on this page. What we need to do is to hover over Advanced Editor and click on it. And now you'll be prompted with this notification saying that you can't revert back to this simple editor mode if you're going to the advanced editor. That's why we recommend that you add all the information before switching to the advanced mode. So we will click on the advanced editor mode again and click OK. And this is how the advanced editor looks like. Now let's scroll down below and you will see this HES part property, We do not need this anymore, so let's delete it and click yes. Now what we want to do is to scroll to the top and click on Add Property Group. And as you can see here, the keyword is a property group and below it are properties. We scroll below a little, we will see that this is a property group and within it are properties. The same goes for the distribution. This is a larger group and this is the smaller group, and within the smaller group there are properties. And that's what we need to do for the is part of property. If it is too confusing, don't worry, just follow along. For this property group, we need to name it as is part of. Make sure that it is in this exact letter casing because that's how search engines understand it. Following that, within the property group, we need to add property. So let's click on this and a property field will appear. We need a total of 5 properties. So we will click add property 4 more times. And here we go. All right, the first field, we need to define the schema property type for this group. So we will add type. And the type is data set. Please follow exactly the letter casing as I've shown you. And following that, we need to tell search engines the name of this larger data set. So we will add name here. And the name of the data set is WordPress Performance Benchmarks 2025. There are no restrictions on the letter casing in this field, but as best practice, please follow the letter casing for this. And then we need to describe what the data set is about. So we will add description or small letter casing, and then add your description here. Following that, we need to add the URL of the larger report. So we will define URL and add the URL to the larger report. And then it is optional for you to add the license of this larger report. And similarly, it is going to be the privacy policy. And then finally, this is also an optional property, which is to tell the search engines about the creator of this larger report. And to do that, we need to add a group and name it as creator. Let's add 2 properties within the creator group. First, we will have it as add type. This will either be a person or organization, depending on your use case. But for us, let's say that the creator is me. So it will be a person. And the name of the person or organization is Jack Chow. And we are done. This is how you add the is part of property. Let's save for this post and save or publish the report. And now let's test it. Let's visit the page, view its page source, copy everything, and go to the Google's Reach Results Testing tool. Paste the codes here and let's test it. Give it a while. And there you go. It has detected 2 data sets. And on this is part of data set, there are no errors or issues, which means it is properly added. As we check out the other issue, it is missing the field creator, which is exactly the same thing as we did. And if we want to fix this issue, it is very easy. Let's check out the data set again. And because this data set describes this report, which is the smaller report. So what we want to do is to add the creator group as we did earlier. So let's click Add Property Group, which is part of this data set for this report. And let's scroll all the way to the bottom. So this creator group is for the larger data set. And this new creator group that I'm adding is for the smaller data set. So similarly, we will have add type, person, name will be the name of the researcher, and let's save for this post. Let's do the same thing again. View page source, copy everything, go to the Reach Results Testing tool, and test it. Give it a while, and here we go. We have solved the problems, and a tool has picked up the 2 data sets. So that's how you can easily add dataset schema to your pages to be featured on Google's dataset search tool and other relevant places to get the most reach for your research report. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment down below and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic, and if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.